Good afternoon. Good afternoon, and welcome to the commencement exercises for Meadowdale High School. I am America Henson, assistant principal. Before we begin this joyous ceremony, please turn off your cell phones or place them on airplane mode. Also, please be courteous to those around you by refraining from talking during the ceremony. We encourage you to express your pride and enthusiasm by applauding and cheering, but please keep in mind that everyone wants to hear their child's name be called. Now that we have gotten that out of the way, please welcome to the stage the pastor of Maranatha Church, Dr. Truman Martin.
Shall we bow in the proclamation of his presence? The creator of the ends of the earth and father of all mankind, the source of all truth, to you we pray for our graduates of Meadowdale High School. We thank you for their achievement. We praise you for their wisdom and understanding. We ask you to guide them in their decision-making processes, that they may excel in leadership, scholarship, and service, that they may come alive to the fulfillment of joy and destiny and continue their education. We pray for the parents, family, and friends of our graduates. We give praise for their perseverance and dedication to see their sons and daughters graduate. We ask you to empower them with a greater sense and a greater measure of nurture and guidance. May they find ongoing joy and satisfaction in the accomplishments of their graduates. We pray for the faculty and staff and administration who have guided the class of graduates throughout their years of study. We give thanks for their leadership, scholarship, teaching, and service. We ask that you empower them to persevere in the ongoing work of shaping and transforming lives of young people who have lost hope and direction for their lives. Thank you for their compassionate service and dedication to this community, that future graduates may attain to greater heights of achievements as those who graduate today. We pray for the Meadowdale community of students, faculty, staff, and alumni. We give praise for the great cloud of witness who provide vision for this school and community of learning. We ask you to inspire hearts for justice, mercy, and guide our community toward healing, wholeness, and reconciliation. This we pray in the name of him who has come that we may have life and have it more abundantly, Christ the Lord Jesus. Amen.
Thank you, Dr. Mark. Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the commencement exercises for the class of 2017. My name is Jason Bates, a proud Meadowdale graduate from the class of 2017. Please remain standing and join me while we recite the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Good afternoon again. Please instruct them to let the outside guests in at this time.
Good afternoon. My name is Antea Allen, salutatorian of class of 2017. Today is a wonderful day to celebrate. It is a day that commemorates the culmination of our journey. As we embark our new journeys, journeys full of challenges and new opportunities, remember that we can survive anything. We were built to last. In life, the things that go wrong are usually the thing that leads to go right. Today is the day we embrace all of our hard work and determination. On behalf of the class of 2017, I want to thank all our parents, staff, administrators, and counselors for supporting us through our journey. With that, please enjoy our ceremony and congratulations to my class, our class, the Meadowdale High School class of 2017.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the 55th graduation exercises for Meadowdale High School. I am Dr. Donitris Hill, 14th principal of this institution of learning. You can clap, that's good news. Meadowdale High School has a rich tradition of excellence, an achievement coupled with passion and spirit, an element that is being restored through hard work, determination, and an unyielding desire for excellence, catalyzed by the notion that every student that enters the building is worth fighting for. Worth fighting for. A phrase you will hear repeatedly, just as you have heard since my arrival. What we value, what we protect, what we hold dear to our hearts and soul, our children, are worth fighting for. Ideology, philosophy, and perspective all fall by the wayside if we don't remember that the children we serve and educate are worth fighting for. So today, we celebrate their accomplishments, and though it has not been easy, let me be the first to say, graduates, well done. For eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has entered into your hearts what God has planned for each and every one of you. Remember, your purpose is worth fighting for. Joining us to celebrate your magnanimous accomplishments today, as I call your names, please stand and be recognized. Representing the Dayton Board of Trustees and Central Administration, President Dr. Robert Walker. Superintendent of Schools, Ms. Rhonda Kaur. Executive Cabinet Members, Associate Superintendent for Student Services, Dr. Sheila Burton, Chief Academic Officer, Dr. Mark A. Winston, Chief of Exceptional Children, Dr. Gregory Roberson, Chief of Schools, Ms. Wyetta Hayden, and Chief of Schools, Mr. Robert Buckheim. Thank you. You may be seated. And also standing with us in spirit and in truth is our partner and spiritual advocate, Dr. Truman Martin, pastor of Maranatha Church. Please give him a hand. Thank you all. Your support and presence here are greatly appreciated. The essence of being a public educator is to understand what it means to serve. In this role, administrators and counselors give of themselves tirelessly because of the quintessential belief and notion that children and their education is worth fighting for. I am surrounded by a cadre of administrators that understand just how important it is to embrace the challenge of educating children while setting goals with expectations and enforcement. It's not an easy job, but there are five people that can do it with consistency and concern. When I call your names, please stand and be recognized. And everyone that is entering, and all those that are, as we are anticipating, please, as we asked at the beginning, please temper your conversations so we can have a very successful program. Thank you. Please stand and be recognized. Assistant Principal, America Henson. Dean of Students, Taylor Porter. Assistant Principal, Ms. Karen Cicchetti. Counselor, Ms. Yvonne Thomas. And Senior Counselor, Ms. Zuleika Wright. Thank you. You may be seated. And I would be remiss to not appreciate the support and dedication of some very talented, battle-tested educators who give of themselves each and every day. They understand that your children's dreams and goals are worth fighting for, and as a result, they travel from all over the greater Dayton area to provide instruction, support, and mentorship to our students. At this time, will all teachers and staff members stand and be recognized? Thank you. Now, graduates, here's the fun part. Please take a moment. Don't move, just take a moment. Find your families. Just look for them. Families, wait, they got instructions. Wait. Okay, graduates. Graduates, I want you to find them as you've done. I want you to blow them a kiss. I want you to smile at them. All right. As you gaze at them with appreciation, okay, as you gaze at them with appreciation, I want you to think about the sacrifices your parents, guardians, and family members have demonstrated throughout your life. Things like school clothes. I hear an amen already. School clothes, pencils, bus tokens, calculators, senior fees, computers, shoes, groceries, rent, working double shifts, getting two jobs, and the list goes on and on. These are the sacrifices that were made to get you to this point. And they have done this for more than 17 or 18 years. Just for you, because you are worth fighting for. I'm reminded of the words of the urban philosopher, Mr. Tupac Shakur, who penned a prolific dissertation entitled, Dear Mama. And in that he said, when I was sick as a little kid, to keep me happy, there's no limit to the things you did. And all my childhood memories are full of all the sweetest things you did for me. And even though I act what? Crazy. I gotta thank the Lord that you made me. And there's no words that express how I feel. You never kept a secret, always stay real. And I appreciate how you raised me. All right, you know it. Listen, think about it. Without them, you would not be sitting here today about to get your high school diploma. So as you reflect on your parents, at this time, all parents, please stand and be recognized. Thank you. So, parents, I know that as you look back at your children, they're sitting there looking all handsome and beautiful in their robes, nice cords and medals. I know many of you are saying to yourself, Dr. Hill, can you please hurry this up and get finished so I can get back to the house and fry this fish and take the ribs off the grill? Because we got 47 people coming to the house, and this party we're about to have is about to be turned. But I want you to know that this is a day for you as well as for them. So now, the important stuff. The report to the superintendent and to the board. Upon my arrival in December, Superintendent Core, Board of Trustees, there were 18 students on track to graduate. Today, May 21st, 2017, I am pleased to report that before you, there are 67 students who realized their diploma was worth fighting for. Will all students graduating in the top 10% because you knew being the best was worth fighting for, please stand to be recognized. Will all students entering the military because you recognize our freedom is worth fighting for, please stand and be recognized. Thank you. Will all students entering a 2-4 or technical trade college because you know that the calling on your life is worth fighting for, please stand and be recognized. Thank you, you may be seated. And to go with this class by means of scholarships and financial aid, the class of 2017 has amassed more than $880,000 in monetary support as they pursue their goals and aspirations, because we also know that being debt-free is worth fighting for. So congratulations. To close, I'm from Texas, as most of you know. And in Texas, the state motto is, don't mess with Texas. And I encourage all of you listening to know that Meadowdale will succeed. So just as we say, don't mess with Texas, don't mess with Meadowdale. We are not Meadow Jail. That reputation is dying today with this graduating class. So stop saying it and stop using it. Because Meadowdale is a school that is worth what? God bless each of you, and congratulations to the class of 2017.
Howdy. How y'all doing? All right. To the faculty, staff, administration, parents, relatives, guests, and anyone who is here, my name is Michael Marsh, and I have the honor of introducing myself as the valedictorian for the class of 2017. I haven't said anything yet. I have been tasked with rendering the farewell. Now, how do you say farewell to a place you've been in for 4 years? Well, what is a speech? Speech is a whole bunch of words. And the words that come to my mind when I think of Meadowdale, there's about four of them, right? There's achievement, right? There's a celebration that we're having right now, right? There's exhaustion from all the preparations, the exasperation from the frustration. I didn't mean to rhyme there, but I'm glad I did. Man, I'm tired. And I know that many of you are right there with me. Like, our class has been through and gone through a lot, you know? There was the impromptu field trip we went on halfway across town on the 8th or 7th bomb threat, can't remember which one. There was the time that we lost our homecoming, right, because of the fight that broke out at one of those same bomb threats. Swear to you, true story. There was a time we had to switch principals. And then the other time, we had to switch principals. And oh yeah, we had to switch principals that other time. We've gone through a lot of principals, haven't we? But don't worry, there were good times, you know, like, yeah, how about those good times? Ooh, and the teachers. Well, the teachers who were not here, were not here this year, please stand up so we can give you a hand. See, they weren't here. Let's not focus on them, though. Let's focus on the teachers who were here. The amazing teachers at Meadowdale, evidenced by their attendance today, teachers like Mr. Bornhorst, the nerdiest man on this side of the Miami River. Teachers like Mr. Davis, who have a versatile set of skills, teaching chemistry and rapping on the side. Thank you. Teachers like Miss Gabby, the silliest, most precious woman I have ever met. Aside from my mom, of course. Love you, mom. I appreciate all y'all. And thing is, you will not be forgotten, you know? Even if you're the kind of teachers who give the meanest mug in the hallway, even though you mean well. Even if you're the kind of teachers who tell you to take out your headphones, even situations where you think, why should I have to take out my headphones? That's fine. Even if you have the compulsion to put the phrase worth fighting for after literally everything you say. I appreciate you. Because these teachers were here. They did for us, right? Even on the worst of days, even on the days where you're the least appreciative, even on the days where you're the most disrespectful, meanest thing that I've ever come into contact with, I've had those days, we all have, there was somebody in this building, right here, for you. And that's nothing to scoff at. See, we all know Meadowdale's reputation, right? I've taken a few pot shots at it myself today. We're loud, we yell a lot, we argue all day, right? But that's just because we have something to say. You know, the fact that we're headstrong, that we seem like we won't be silenced, that's a good thing. That's because we're being real with you. And I'm proud to sit in a building every day where people can be real with you. Because, and I pray you won't impale me for the cheese that is about to come here, but this school made us lion-like. It made us loud. It made us proud. It made us people who will not be silenced. And people will rip your head off if you challenge any one of us. And in case you haven't noticed today, we have no inside voice. We may not be the best school, but this is our school. And made us who we are. Congrats, Meadowdale Lions.
These are our points.
Thank you to our valedictorian. Superintendent Core, with the powers entrusted to me by the Dayton Board of Education, I hereby request your consideration of the candidates for graduation. These students have met or exceeded the requirements set forth by the Ohio Department of Education and the Dayton Public Schools, having successfully completed at least 20 Carnegie units and the required courses, and having passed all five parts of the Ohio graduation test. Superintendent Kaur, I present for your acceptance the class of 2017 of Meadowdale High School.
Thank you, Principal. Good afternoon and greetings to the Board of Education members, our board president, members of my cabinet, staff, teachers, parents, family, and especially our Meadowdale graduates. I'm honored to stand before you today as your superintendent, and I want to wish you the very best to the class of 2017. Today is commencement day. It brings to a close one chapter of your life, but commencement is truly about the beginning. It's a new beginning. It's a new chapter. So no matter where you're from, your dreams are valid, so dream big. I guess I should say dream Dallas big or Texas big. As Walt Disney said, all our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them. So pursue them fiercely and with great passion. You will embark on new journeys today. Many of you, as was mentioned earlier, will be attending colleges. And congratulations once again to this class that has earned nearly $1 million in scholarship money. Let's give them a hand, please. Some of you will go off to join our armed services. Many will start employment. Never lose sight of your dreams, and don't ever let anyone tell you what you cannot do. You may have to leave your comfort zone to grow, but with hard work and some risk, you'll discover who you really are. Keep the faith and always, always believe in yourselves. We do. You are all loved a great deal by your families that are gathered here today in the audience, by your staff, by the community, and beyond. Always remember, we need people in our lives that care about us as individuals and who want the best for us. Stay close to those people. Know your circle and be good to those that always have your back. These people, many of whom are here today, your families, your cousins, your sisters, your brothers, they are both priceless and irreplaceable. At some point, you will have to make difficult decisions through this journey called life. We all have. But be both reflective and mindful of your elders, your mentors, and the people that have supported you. Robert Frost's poem, "The Road Not Taken," is the perfect example. There will come a time when roads diverge, and you will have to choose your path. Take the one less traveled, and it will make all the difference in the world. Dare to be different. Dare to be exceptional. Dare to become greater. Be determined to succeed and continue down the path, regardless of barriers, to be the change. You are our next generation of leaders. We need you, and we are counting on you. And I'm going to quote Kanye West. Never stop fighting, no matter what anyone says. If it's in your gut, your soul, there's nothing, no worldly possession, that should come between you and your expression. Once again, on behalf of the Dayton Board of Education, our entire staff, congratulations on your commencement from high school today. Best wishes in all of your future endeavors. We are your supporters, and we will be cheering you on every step of the way because you're worth fighting for. Dear Principal, as the Superintendent of Schools, and by the powers entrusted to me by the Ohio Department of Education and the Dayton Board of Education, I do hereby accept these candidates for graduation and release their diplomas to be presented in this ceremony. Board President Walker, it is my honor to commend to you the high school class of Meadowdale, class of 2017.
Good afternoon. Honored guests, administrators, faculty, support staff, friends, parents, grandparents, all family members, stakeholders, Superintendent Core, and Principal Dr. Hill, on behalf of the Dayton Board of Education, my members are Dr. Adil Bagaroff, Joe Lacey, Ron Lee, Dr. Hazel Roundtree, Mr. John McManus, and Sheila Taylor. We extend a hearty congratulations to this Meadowdale class of 2017. And graduates, you have spent 4 years with us, and your days with DPS has come to a close. But it's our hope that you will take what you've learned and you will become the leaders in our community, not in the future, but tomorrow. Because our world is looking for the gift that you will bring. And we are excited about some of your achievement. Mr. Marsh, I see why you're headed to, I think it's Texas Christian University. The University of Dayton. Thank you. Yeah, I see why you're headed to the University of Dayton. I think with a full ride. Congratulations. Mr. Lawrence, who won the gold medal for indoor track in the 400-meter dash and set a state record in Division I. Now, he will attend TCU, Texas Christian University. And we want to note the hard work of the seniors who've gone through several transitions, as Mr. Marsh has reminded us. And you've made a significant statement to not only Dayton Public Schools, but for the city of Dayton and the Dayton Public School District. So graduates, each one of you are destined for success with unlimited potential. Remember, as you journey through life, there will be times of doubt, uncertainty, and fear. But do not let these challenges detour or paralyze you. You are prepared to navigate and to overcome all obstacles. The world, again, is awaiting for your gifts and your contributions. Remember that you are prepared for the workforce. You are prepared for college. You are prepared for career training of the armed forces. But what I will do, I will conclude my remarks by sharing with you these words from the late Dr. Benjamin E. Mays, the former president of Morehouse College. He says, "The tragedy of life is often not in our failure, but rather in our complacency. Not in our doing too much, but rather in doing too little. Not in our living above our ability, but rather in our living below our capacity." So we simply, as this Dayton Public School District, look for you to continue to live above your abilities. So with that, Superintendent Core, on behalf of the Dayton Board of Education, I accept these students commended to me by the superintendent, that's yourself, and they shall be hereforth deemed graduates of the Dayton Public Schools, and they shall be hereforth bestowed with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities afforded the graduates of this high school, of this system, school system. Congratulations and best wishes, Superintendent Core, the Meadowdale graduating class of 2017.
Good afternoon, family and friends. Again, we want to respectfully ask you all to hold your applause to the end so that no one is missed on this great moment. Aaliyah Shafiq. Antea Allen. Michael Marsh. Jason Bates. Shamia Allen. Nicholas Allen. Jaya Bailey. Damon Baker II. Jasmine Bankston. Christian Barnett Britton. Shamar Benton. Anthony Boyd. Deontay Oliver. Armani Newton. DeWatt Morris. Darius Morris. Brandon McCoy. Rayvon McClendon. Mikeia McCain. Megan Nath. Christopher Brooks. Edward Cantrell. Sean Clay Jr. DeMar Coulter. Kenneth Cook. Ariana Crump. Kayla Crutcher. Jaquan Dean. Joseph Rutledge III. Christian Roman. Ryan Rickman. Brian Rickman. Cameron Red. Raven Rapley. LaVon Randall. Deja Brianne Parks. Latasha Grady. Serenity Grant Love. Jeremy Isaacs II. Daryl Jackson. Champagne Jones. Coriana Johnson. Shanae Judkins Jr. Desiree Knowlton. Miracle Wallace. Ronald Thornton. Tavion Tanner. Tiana Stevens. Shamika Stevens. Malik Smith. Levi Smith Jr. Jasmine Scott. Wayne Lawrence Jr. Isaiah Leroy. Dennis Lachlan. Mark Malone. Noah Davis. Skyla Woodard. Sierra Young. Kaylin Winston. Darius Williams. Adrian Wilkerson. Carlos Whiting. Julian Finch. Family and friends, help me congratulate the Meadowdale class of 2017.
Dr. Walker, Superintendent Core, Executive Cabinet, Administration, teachers, parents, and family members, it is my duty and privilege to announce the graduating class of 2017. By the powers vested, as prescribed by the state of Ohio and Dayton Public Schools, I introduce you as graduates. Graduates, at this time, please move your tassel from right to left.
Alma mater. If we could get the Meadowdale alumni to join us in singing the alma mater, please everybody stand and join us in singing the alma mater. Ms. Cummings, Ms. Applegate, please lead us. Ms. Applegate, come and lead us. Distinguished guests.